Brendan Polkina, agronomist and certified crop advisor with the Arthur Companies out of our Pillsbury location. On today's edition, we're going to talk about head scab applications in both wheat and barley. To start off, we're going to talk barley. Barley flowers in the boot, so applications for head scab are actually going to occur post-flowering right as the head emerges. You'll see in the image that's going to pop in front of you right now that we have heads in this picture that are too early for application, on time for application, and too late for application. So as you're scouting your fields, make sure to make note of that timing. Next, we'll hop into wheat. This morning, we happen to be standing in a wheat plot where we are reaching optimal timing in some of the varieties. If your camera zooms in here right now, we actually have florets that are out this morning on some of the main stems. This would be Feeks 10.5.1 growth stage, and this would be optimal timing for application of scab fungicides such as Persaro, Miravis Ace, Corumba, or generic Folicure. This year's timing is going to be rather difficult for several reasons. So as you're out scouting your fields looking for this growth stage, you're going to have a few things that are weighing in. One of them was uneven emergence due to subpar field or planting conditions this spring. That's going to make for uneven stands. So heading windows are going to be all over the place. The second piece that's going to make it difficult is the heat that's in the forecast this week. That's really going to push this wheat crop along very quickly. So we're going to watch wheat crops that go from heading to flowering in a probably 5 to 7 day window, where that should normally be a 10 to 14 day window. So scouting, how to determine when to do a field. This applies to both wheat and barley. With the uneven emergence and the heat that's going to push the crop, it is my opinion that you go and time based on the areas of the field that are going to provide the most yield. Don't go scout hilltops or low areas that may be further along or further behind. Try to hit the areas of the field that are going to provide the most yield in order to protect the most bushels with your head scab application. Some application tips for you. If you're going aerial application because of ground conditions, 4 to 5 gallons of water per acre, and make sure to include a non-ionic surfactant. If you're doing ground rig, 15 to 20 gallons an acre with a flat fan nozzle is recommended for these applications for best results.
Hi, Justin Cutt with the Arthur Companies here. Also wanted to talk quickly about adding insecticide in with a fungicide. Certainly is something we can do. We see recommendations, we get questioned on it all the time. It certainly is a cheap option. For a buck or two an acre, you can throw an insecticide in there and take care of any insects that are out there. I want to challenge that idea just a little bit and say let's scout and see if there's any insects out there. Certainly could be. There's a few aphids out there. Haven't seen anything at economic levels. There's been some reports of fall armyworms, especially in fields that are lodged. Saw some of that on rye early on. Let's just think through that, and let's try not to do the insecticide if we can help it. We only have a couple of good classes of insecticides left, and every time we use that, we do drive ourselves toward resistance issues. There's some older chemistries, and there's a couple brand new ones that work great on aphids, Transform and Savanto, that we need to be around for a long time. So let's try to preserve those chemistries. If you ever need any help determining if you're at economic injury levels for any of these insects, please give an Arthur Companies agronomist a call.